sheep ranch. So Tess, can you tell us a little bit about your operation here?
Well, I got into sheep about 12 years ago. I started with 5 culls and I wanted to train only dogs. I had no intentions of having sheep in a long-term relationship, but here I am with 100 sheep. And we are now into training them to eat weeds, and I'm finding this very exciting because we have a lot of kind of thistle, and I'd kind of like to eliminate that. I don't really like weed whack and thistle, so we're going to train my really smart sheep to eat thistle today.
We
have 101, and the most of them are young. That's supposed to be good for this training program. They're under this 75 of them under a year, so they're good candidates for training to eat new things, and they've done really well this week. They've eaten all of 8 different varieties of feed grains and odd things like creme cheese and alfalfa cubes, and they did really well till day 3, and then they jammed up and said enough of that. They didn't want those alfalfa cubes. That was the big ones.
The cubes that threw them off.
The big ones, yeah. They didn't like those.
So what happened after that? Can you describe that more? They just didn't want to eat?
Yeah, so they just refused them. They went off and laid in the shade, just like that. And no more cooperation that day. We brought them back early that night and added at that time ground flax on top of the cubes. And they decided that was even worse. That was terrible, insulting. And so they went off and laid in the shade some more and ignored it all evening. And the next day we had to add horse crunchies to that, and they had gone back out to the field, their regular routine. And when they came in the fourth night, they ate everything. They thought everything was delicious. So that's sheep for you. If they don't, you can never understand sheep, I'm sure. They're funny little critters. And they make
these are our first day of actual weed training. So yeah. We just went and chopped up a bunch of our weeds. And what are we putting on top of the weeds today?
We're going to put more ground flax on top because it kind of sticks to the plant, I'm told. And they get a taste of something they've had before, and then something new, which maybe they haven't tried in the pasture. So we're going to encourage them to try a ninth new plant, and that's going to be the thistles. And hopefully they'll probably say no to it at first. We're expecting they'll say no for at least 2 days, and then they'll gradually warm up to it, just like they have everything else. I think they're going to be really smart little sheep and cooperate with
good.
Us. I have a good feeling about this.
Have you tried any other sort of weed control on your thistle on your farm?
No, I haven't. I haven't done it purposely, but they do eat a lot of different weeds. I've shepherded them a lot, so I've been on the beaten hills, and there's a lot of invasive weeds, so the ground, the goat's beard, and we have a little bit of orange hawkweed and a few other things, and they clean up those. They just eat it with the rest of the vegetation. So,
but they don't seem to be eating the thistle here.
No, they haven't. They haven't migrated thistle. So that's the critter I'd like to eliminate, or at least cut down to where they're manageable.
Okay, so yeah. I guess our plan for today is we're going to train them on the thistle and open up the thistle pasture and see what happens.
Yes, we're looking forward to it, and I think they will too once they wake up.
It's hot.
Flax on top of thistle.
Lie down.
Thank you. Thank you.